Today I'm going to show you the basics of advanced analytics on Recruit CRM. To go to advanced analytics, you can click on the reports button down here and the advanced analytics tab up here. Once you're inside this tab, on the left side, you'll find three folders: your personal collection, shared collection, and databases. Your personal collection is your private collection that no one else can access. So you can create new charts and dashboard within your personal collection. And once you're happy with the way it looks, you can move it to the shared collection so that your wider team can access it as well. Databases is where we store all of your data. For example, the deals table here will have all of the data related to the deals that you have created on Recruit CRM. This also includes any and all custom column fields that you would have created. Now, let's go back and create a simple bar chart. The way to do that is you can click on the new button up here, click on question, choose tables, and then click on the table name that you want to create your chart. In my case, I want to create a chart on deals, so I'm going to click on deals. Once I do that, it will take me to the query editor page. The main query editor page has three major components: filter, summarize, and group by. Filter is where you choose the field you want to filter your data by. Summarize is for your aggregations like count, sum, average, etc. And group by is your dimensions and categories. In my case, I want to create a bar chart for the total revenue generated by each deal. So in my group by column, I'll choose the deal name. In summarize, I'll do sum of deal value. And I only want those deals that were created in the last 12 months. So I'm going to filter this data to last 12 months. Once I'm happy with the way this looks, I'm going to click on visualize. Then advanced analytics will go back, fetch the data and present it in a tabular format. Now I want to create this data into a bar chart. To do that, I can click on the visualization button down here and it will show me all of the chart options. So all I need to do is click on bar and it will represent the same data in a bar chart format. To format this chart further, for example, I can't see the amount of the revenue on top of the bar. Instead, I have to hover over it. So if I want to add it to the top of the bar, I can click on the settings button down here on the left corner, display and show values on data points. Now I can see the name of the deal, the amount generated by the deal, as well as in a bar chart format. Now that I'm happy with the way this looks, I can go ahead and save the chart. I'm going to save this chart as deals in my personal collection and I'm going to click on save. Once I do that, I'll be prompted to add this chart to the dashboard. I'm going to go ahead and create a new dashboard and add this chart to it. So I'm going to click on dashboards, create a new dashboard. I'm going to click, call it deals, create, and I'm going to click on select. Now a new dashboard named deals has been created and the chart has been added. Before I save this dashboard, I also want to add an additional filter to it. I'm going to click on add a filter button up here and add a time filter or a date filter. So I've added the date filter. I'm going to choose the column I want to filter it by, which is created on, and I'm going to click on done. Once I'm done with that, this dashboard looks good to me. I'm going to save it. Once you do that, your dashboard is ready. The filter is added. Chart is added. You can add more charts as well. It's currently saved in my personal collection. Once I'm happy with the way it looks, I can move it to the shared collection. That's it. It was as easy as that. I hope that helps. Thank you.